I was talking about environment. Mostly people live in the village in Pakistan, and mostly people are illiterate there. On the other hand, mostly families are illiterate or uneducated. So those people will discourage to education. If all relatives are illiterate and uneducated, those people will discourage to knowledge or education. It is also a problem. Most people can't get education. There is discouragement too much in underdeveloped country like Pakistan. Discouragement is very common. And also I tell you one thing very important. Due to unemployment, mostly people are disappointed from education if they don't get job or proper job. Those people also discouraged to education in this situation. It also problem. People have to say that I did 3 masters, but I am jobless. I am unemployed. It is all in vain. It is useless. So it is also a factor. People have to discourage from education and knowledge. On the other hand, I tell you very important factor. I tell about different institutions. I am also teacher. I respect to teachers too much. Excuse me. So, I tell you that mostly teachers, professors, and lecturers, also discourage to students. Every student is very genius. Every student is very talented. Due to discouragement to students from teachers, many students say goodbye to education. So the system of education is stopped in this way. System of knowledge is stopped in this way. Okay, now I want to tell you about benefits. Benefits of knowledge. First of all, if somebody has extraordinary knowledge, person have to achieve his goal. Any person can make familiar in his field by extraordinary knowledge. Somebody can earn much fame by extraordinary knowledge. Somebody have to get respect everywhere by extraordinary knowledge. Somebody can make as a role model by extraordinary knowledge. Somebody can make exemplary by extraordinary knowledge. Somebody can get the success in this world and in other world after death. Any person can make history instead of some, if some, if any person dies, but he will be alive in history forever by extraordinary knowledge. Person is not helpless without knowledge. Person is helpful with extraordinary knowledge. He can guide to any person. He can teach to any person. It is virtue. It is good deed. Person can help to helpless people. If somebody has extraordinary knowledge. First of all, person have to get own benefit by knowledge. Further things that person can, any person can get status in the society by extraordinary knowledge. Any person can make healthy and wealthy by extraordinary knowledge. Any person can make popular by extraordinary knowledge. Any person can earn fame by extraordinary knowledge. If somebody has extraordinary knowledge, he can do job on offer letter in his field. It is actual respect by extraordinary knowledge. So there are numberless benefits of knowledge. There are many benefits of knowledge. There are a lot of types or kinds of knowledge. There are countless, you know, benefits by knowledge. There are numberless benefits of knowledge. Now suggestions, how we can improve our knowledge. First of all, we should study daily. We should get knowledge by our parents and teachers. We should study our religious books with translation. We should sit with scholars. We should listen to scholars. We should learn different languages. First of all, we should prefer to Arabic language. Then we have to prefer other languages. About world languages, we have to prefer English language. Above all, we have to education about world. If we have to get the success in the world, so we have to learn spoken English language by all means. I tell you one thing, that somebody is just matriculate, but he is expert in English language. I give you guarantee, he can good job in Pakistan anywhere. On the other hand, if somebody did masters in any subject, but he can't speak English, he's unconscious about English language, so person will be jobless. Further suggestions that we should be keen observer. In other we must have keen observer. We should be keen observer. How we can get much knowledge? Further suggestion. We have to focus our attention on any work. We need full attention on any work. Then we can get much information. We can get much benefit of knowledge. If we start at a time many works, we can't focus our attention on any work. As a result, we can't get even little knowledge. We can't get even little knowledge, short knowledge. It's the best way to get knowledge we have to focus our attention just on one work, and you know, same time or at a time, we should not start many works. We have to do one work and we have to focus our attention on just one work. Then we can get much knowledge and we can get success. Where is problem? Problem is here that at a time, mostly people have to start many works and divert their attention. If people don't focus on work, and it is the main reason of failures in different fields. If you have to study to leaders, you study to world leaders, then you can find same thing. There is one thing is same in all leaders. Those leaders did one work with full attention just one time. Those people save their precious time and focus their attention on one work and save their precious time and gave good results. And those people are genius people. What is the difference between efficient person and inefficient person? Inefficient person devotes his full attention on work, and inefficient person does not focus his attention on one work. He devotes his attention on different works. So it is a main reason of failure of inefficient person. And what is the reason of success of efficient person? Because that person, efficient person, focused attention just on one work. He did not focus it, his attention on any on different works at a time. It is very precious knowledge. I gave you as a suggestion. And topic is also knowledge. Further suggestion, we should not kill our time. We need planning. What time we have to do what work, so we have to get much knowledge. Especially, I want to tell you one thing, that nowadays it is very easy. It is very easy to get knowledge and information by IT. We can get much knowledge. We can go any website and we can get knowledge in few moments about anything. It is the easiest time to get knowledge. Problem is where? Due to misplanning, people don't make their timetables. And people have to face many failures. Is the main reason behind? People don't plan their lives. As a result, people have to kill their time. So we should, first of all, as a Muslim, we should follow the Holy Quran. We should follow to Allah and Holy Prophet, peace be upon him. I give you guarantee, inshallah, we can get success everywhere. And on the other hand, we should follow to our to leaders. We should study to leaders. We should study the lives of leaders. We should follow to our leaders. And after prayer, we must pray, we should pray in front of Allah. My Lord, increase me in knowledge. In Arabic, Rabbe Zidni Ilma. In English, my Lord, increase me in knowledge. Inshallah, Allah will give you too much knowledge. I swear of Allah. And I swear of Holy Prophet, peace be upon him. In the end, my point of view, knowledge is everything. And knowledge has importance for us, like soul is inside in the human body. Why we are survive? Because soul is inside the body, so we are alive. Same here. Knowledge has importance for us like this. I have to close my briefing here. I think that you have to get much knowledge.
Yes, sir.
It was very important. So I gave you briefing again on knowledge. You can discuss with people regarding these points, and you can increase the knowledge of other people. If you have to get knowledge from me, I also got knowledge from my teacher, my respected teachers, my parents. It is system. You know, I transfer my knowledge towards you. You have to spread this knowledge among people, in your relatives, in your friends, in your cousins. It is virtue, it's a good deed. I expect you that you will follow my instructions. Any question regarding knowledge, you can ask me now. Anyone? Yes, Fadlur Rahman, Zubair, Zain, Sajjad. Tariq is here today or not now? Tariq is not. Usman Ghani? Okay.
No, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
You know that I think now it is also, you know, that you can prepare well your test, on coming Saturday. Same here, you can get lecture from YouTube, today's lecture, okay? Today's briefing you can get from YouTube as usual. After the class, this lecture will upload on YouTube. So, inshallah, tomorrow I have to start new briefing.
Inshallah, sir.
Inshallah. So I think class have to go end now. Inshallah, you need much practice, on today's and yesterday's topic or briefing. Inshallah, we have to meet again tomorrow. Wish you good luck. Allah Hafiz.
Salaam.
Thank you. Allah Hafiz.